First, before we get to that, we want to bring you a significant new development that we have learned in an ABC7 iTeam investigation. Now, we've been investigating serious problems within the D.C. Fire and EMS Department, which could affect your safety if you face an emergency.
And now ABC7 has obtained a new report which reveals some shocking revelations over the use and maintenance of ambulances. Roz Plater live outside fire headquarters with the story you'll want to see tonight. Roz?
Allison, that report paints a picture of a backup system or fleet of emergency vehicles that seems in disarray. Tonight, one D.C. City Council member says that's not what they were told by the fire chief, and he's asking, what's up? Emergency vehicles that wouldn't even start, some waiting for repairs for more than 2 years. Ambulances not stocked with needed medical supplies for fear they'll be stolen. Allegations some vehicles may even have been sabotaged. Just some of the findings in a new report from the city's inspector general about the state of the D.C. Fire and EMS reserve fleet.
Need to get them fixed, that's all I can say.
I just think it's like sad, like to do people like that.
D.C. City Councilman Tommy Wells, who heads the Public Safety Committee, says he's confused. The report runs contrary to what Fire Chief Kenneth Ellerby told him about the reserve fleet at a hearing just last month.
Was he running the fire department with false information that he was dependent upon, which puts all our citizens at risk? Or was he not being truthful and transparent when he spoke to the council in the oversight of the committee? If there's a problem, he's either got to fix it or he's got to ask for help.
We reached out to the fire department spokesperson for a direct response. What we got instead was the fire chief's statement about the report, saying in part, we've already begun moving forward on the recommendations. The department also has ordered several vehicles that will include new ladder trucks, pumpers, and ambulances to support our emergency response needs. Now, all of this comes as the Firefighters Union is calling for a vote of no confidence on Monday for the chief. We've also learned tonight that a separate group, the Progressive Firefighters Association, is calling for a rally on Monday to support the chief. So stay tuned. We're live in Northwest D.C. I'm Roz Plater, ABC 7 News.